click the photo, which will take you to your photo gallery. And here's the photo, so I'm gonna click it, and then it's gonna open the project here. And if you wanna just make sure that your dimensions are okay, then you can go up here to Canvas, click Canvas information, and see it's 1080 times 1350. And that's what we want, so click Done. And now let's have a look at the animation timeline. So let's go up here, and then we're gonna go to Canvas, and then you see the animation assist over here, and you're gonna tap that. Now you see the animation timeline has appeared in the bottom here. For now, we have two frames. One is the color palette, and one is the background. If you just tap this one and say combine down, they're now in a group, which means when you work with the animation timeline, that it's one frame. This is gonna be our background throughout the project. So let's go down here. You have different options that I will take you through now. If you tap on our first frame, like this, you see some different options. First is the hold duration. That's how many frames your certain layer is gonna last for. So you can turn that all the way up to max, which is more than 100. And that will be a long time. We don't want that. Usually it would be maybe 1, 2, 3, up to 10 seconds if you need that. Let's say you will have it last for 4 frames. Next one is delete. You can delete it. We don't want to do that. You know how that works. And then we have the foreground option, which will keep this layer always in the layers panel. So this could be, let's say if you had some clouds up here and you wanted the clouds to be present on top of every single frame throughout the animation. And for the rest of the function, I would like to show you a project that I worked earlier. It's called Bouncing Boops. Let's go to the first frame. So now we've had a look at how you can change and play around with each frame when you tap it down here. Then we also have the play function. So when you tap that, funny enough, it's gonna play. Then you have some settings over here. Right now we have the loop option tapped, and that means that the whole animation is looping, looping for all eternity. Then you can tap the ping pong. It's gonna play forward and then it's gonna play backward. And then you have one shot, which really just is the animation being played one time and then it stops. We would like it to loop. And then down here we have frames per second. Right now it's on 10 frames per second. And we can make it higher. So the more frames per second, the quicker the animation is. And then we have the onion skin frames. That means, let's go to the first frame and you tap this one time. You'll see the next frame faded. So you know how to draw each frame so they are connected and work well with the previous one. You wouldn't be able to create smooth, nice cell animation if you didn't have this function. You can also have several onion skin frames. That means that you can see a lot of the frames that you already created. Usually I just have it on one. And then we have the onion skin opacity. You can drag it up and down, depends on how visible you want it. You also have these two last options down here, and I rarely use them, and you can feel free to play around with them. The color secondary frames, for example, will color the next frame and the previous one in green. And this one will color your whole, like, current frame in another color, which might be useful for you, but not really anything I like to use. And then we have the last option down here, which is add frame. It kind of like speaks for itself. Tap it and you will get a new frame.